up, guys? It's Thursday and Action Bronson's in town. Tia just surprised me with early birthday tickets to go and have dinner with him. So I'm super excited about that. Also, a part of my birthday gift, she got me this vest from a brand called A Field Out. And it's pretty sick. I actually love the colors. I love how light it is. It's really comfortable. So I styled it with this all black Zara tee, packed some pants, and this camo Boston Red Sox hat with my black Movado watch and my chain from my grandparents that I have right here. This is gonna be my look for tonight. I'm super excited. I get to hang out with Action Bronson.
All right guys, so mid filming, we realized it was 5:45 and our dinner's at 6. So we just got here, we rushed to Fairfax. Got here on time, they're still setting up. So right now we're just waiting for them to open the doors so we can eat.
Fooled by my college degree. My IQ is average. There's a young lady out there, she way smarter than me. I scroll through her timeline in these wild times and I started to read. She mad at these crackers, she mad at these capitalists, mad at these murder police. She mad at my niggas, she mad at her ignorance, she wear her heart on the sleeve. She mad at the celebrities, low key I be thinking she talking about me. Now I ain't no dummy to think I'm above criticism, so when I see something that's valid I listen, but shit, there's something about the queen tone that's bothering me. She strike me as somebody blessed enough to grow up in conscious environment with parents that know about the struggle for liberation, and in turn they provide her with a perspective and awareness of the system and a fairness that afflicts them, and the clearest understanding of what we gotta do to get free. And the frustration that fills the words seems to come from the fact that most people don't see. Just cause you woke and I'm not, that shit ain't no reason to talk like you better than me. How you gon' leave when you attacking the very same niggas that really do need the shit that you saying? Instead of command, you holier, come help us get her to speed. Shit is a reason into like 200 years for our answers to just to get free.
She says you're my everything, I love you through everything. I done did everything to her, she forgave me for everything. This a forever thing. Hate that I treat it like it's a whatever thing. Trust me, girl, this shit is everything to me.
Jesus. So, guys, we made it to the beach. It took us about 4 hours, but we're here. The plan was to go in the morning, but
we had a slow Sunday.
So now we're here and we're gonna make the best of it. We were gonna plan to go to this secret location, but not today.
If I need to talk, are you around? Are you down for the cause? Are you down? Are you down? Are you down? Are you down for the cause? Are you down? Are you down? Are you down? Are you down for the cause? You still down, you still down, you still down.
Barely anybody here. It's just us and a few other paddleboarders and neighborhood people, but it's the best to have an empty beach.
Girls that got me nervous. They go to school and do bottle service. They can't decide, they keep switching majors. Being indecisive makes me anxious. Call your number and it's out of service. Can I call for your information? What am I supposed to do after we done everything that we done? Who is your replacement?
Oh, he's still good, oh, he's still good.
So beautiful. It's how we spend our Sundays. I feel blessed to be able to do this. It's chilly, I feel wet, but it's worth it. What did I just found? A huge ass crystal. Holy shit. Crazy. I'm telling you right now, this is my greatest find. Once this gets cut, you're gonna see all the crystal inside. It's got this shell. Here, you can see the crystals inside the rock. So I'm excited for this.
All right, guys, it's time for us to head back. Got about an hour and a half, maybe 2 hour drive. So it's time to get out of here. But it was fun, it was worth it. I always like to come here to reset and enjoy the day.
These stairs, you can never get used to them, but it's worth it. I'm tired.
Where do you think hip-hop's at right now?
It's about to reset. The whole music industry is about to reset itself. It usually happens like that, you know. Repetition, breakthrough, originality, we back on again.
Yeah.
That's what the music industry is about, you know. Right now, talent is not at the foreground, but talent will be put back into the foreground.
Why do you feel like talent's not?
Because it's so easy to make music. You can go Instagram, Snapchat, this, that, 15 seconds of fame. I'm a star, I'm this, I'm that, I got followers, I got likes. The motherfuckers ain't following you. But you know, you got that philosophy that you can be a star. When I came up, you had to have conversation. You had to have showmanship. You had to have, you know, you had to rap through the microphone. Like, not play the song and rap over the song. You had to, like, I'm gonna hear you just like I heard you on a record. I need to hear you on stage. And I believe that element has been taken out, but it will be, you know, reinstated.
Yeah. Do you have people coming up who you feel like will be a part of that?
There's a lot of people making great music right now, and they should be, you know, commended, but there's so many to name. And a lot of times the bad rap is always the ones who don't do it right, but there are people who are doing it correctly. And the music industry is gonna continue to, you know, be diversified, and it's gonna continue to reach different parts of the world. I didn't think hip hop would be in Africa, Japan, Turkey, and India, but it's there, and it's loved and it's respected, so it's gonna continue to grow.
I'll ask you one more West Coast question. Since I know the answer, where did you land on the Kendrick Drake beef?
Where did I land?
Yeah. What did you make of it?
I was in the sky smoking weed. That's where I landed, you know what I'm saying? Because, like, when grown men have, you know, situations as another grown man, it's your job to get out their motherfucking way. And let them handle their business, you know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, they both my nephews. So whatever misunderstanding or disagreement that they have, I'm pretty sure they could get an understanding without Uncle Snoop getting involved.
Right.
I got to finish where we started. So you did the Olympics. I've heard you talk over the years about your desire to be part of the broadcast booth for a Super Bowl. You're a huge football fan. Did you take a moment in Paris to talk to the NBC folks and put in a pitch for the Super Bowl?
Let him get that call real quick.
You good?
No, my grandmother always told me, let your work speak for you. Like, so it shouldn't be about me having to converse and talk to nobody. My work speaks for me. Like, I think that when I'm in front of the microphone, no matter what sport it is, whatever the event is, I'm gonna give you something you've never seen before. I'm gonna say things in an appropriate manner. I know how to clean things up and broadcast. You know, if you see the Olympics was rated G.
Yeah, it was great.
It was rated motherfucking G, and I was able to keep it G the whole way. And that was one of the main concerns that I'm pretty sure that NBC had. I hope this motherfucker don't say that on TV. And I kept it, you know what I'm saying?
They trusted you enough to put you on broadcast. I feel like they put Alex Cooper on the online stream.
It's gravy though, because my mother told me, you know what I'm saying, when you get opportunities, son, make the most of it, because you never know who's watching.
Yeah. Well, Snoop, thank you so much for doing this.
Thank you, Lucas.
Oyster mushroom sandwich and truffle fries. Has lettuce, tomatoes, and like a vegan mayo. Hitting. The fries, I got a habanero aioli dipping sauce and ketchup. The habanero sauce is really good. So I'm really happy they provided plant-based meals for this event, because they're actually really good.
Hey, what's up, guys? Today is another fun day. We're heading to the gym. Well, I just got some fun news. I got hired by the Clippers. I'm going to be a part of the Chuck crew, which is their hype men. I'm going to be on the court, throwing shirts, hyping the crowd up, just bringing in the atmosphere, which is a cool thing. Everybody knows I'm a Celtics fan, but to have this type of opportunity, I cannot turn it down. I went through the auditions. It was a lot of fun, scary, but a lot of fun, because there were so many dancers there. And I was like, shit, I'm not a dancer, but I can definitely bring live energy and support the crowd and, like, you know, just help the Clippers out getting the job done. And maybe we see a championship ring this year. We never know. So, and what's also cool is that I get to be a part of the new stadium, Intuit Stadium. Their first season is this year at the new stadium. So it's gonna be exciting. Hopefully we get a championship this year. But yeah, right now I am heading to the gym, about to ball up with some of my friends. One of the guys that I am not working with is here today, so we can talk about our experience.
I just put a wagon in the driveway, you know I did. When I shoot my shot, it's still on highways.
Alright guys, so I just finished ball. I'm headed back to the crib. Had a very good run. I was sweating like a beast. One guy just kept on shooting lights out. Can I tell you? There's nothing I could do to guard him. Literally, there's nothing I could do to guard him. But it'd be like that sometimes. Next time though, I didn't record him because it wasn't full court games. But next time, I definitely want to record some full court games, because there is some good run there that happens. And the guys are super competitive. It was a lot of fun. Now I'm starving. Gonna head home, shower, and then get some food. What's up, guys? So today is game day for the Clippers. I'm driving to work right now as we speak. I am excited. We start against, so game opener is against Phoenix, the Phoenix Suns. So we're coming on strong, and hopefully we start off with a W.
Promise that you will think about me. Promise that you will think about me.